The year is 2020. The hoax, more commonly known as the coronavirus, continues to impact all aspects of our lives. Protests and rioting by groups such as Black Lives Matter and Antifa have led to an increase in crime and violence in our communities. And a radical movement to destroy our nation's core conservative values.
Let me turn this off. Now, if you really want to know what happened during 2020, watch this.
Honestly, thought that that was true until I gave this motherfucker like a month or two. This is getting kind of ridiculous at this point. Yo, my cat died.
Hey, Prairie View Panthers, I'm Zanaria Bonds. I'm going around asking two questions. Would you rather receive a college degree or survive 2020? And describe 2020 in one word. Come out and follow us and check us out. If y'all could describe 2020 in one word, what would it be?
Atrocious.
Okay.
Disappointing.
There we go.
Disappointing.
Disgusting. All same, kind of tragic.
Would you rather survive 2020 or get a college degree?
Survive 2020.
Why is that?
I really just don't want to die.
He doesn't want to die. Yeah. Nobody wants to die.
I'd rather survive. Okay, because if you survive, you can get a college degree.
Right.
Period.
Right.
It's always
still.
How y'all feel about Trump in 2020?
I mean, Trump. Oh, it's a black man. Black man. Always got something to say. Real brother right here.
I mean, speak on the player. A lot of people have his opinions about him, but you know, like policy wise, I can respect what he does. You know what I'm saying? But as far as him, you know, as a person, you know, I can't agree with everything he does, but he's willing to work with the African Americans.
So, brother man,
he's willing to work with us.
On that note.
Hey USC Trojans, I'm Stephen Vargas, and I'm going around campus asking people two questions. Describe 2020 in one word, and how do you feel about the presidential elections? Let's go. Describe 2020 in one word.
Chaos. Confusing.
Complicated.
Chaos. I feel like I would choose adaptability.
And how do you feel about the presidential election?
I want to say hopeful. Government in general is kind of hard to trust at this point.
There's just extra stress when it really shouldn't have had to be.
Right.
I wouldn't say Biden is my first choice, but definitely a lot better than the last.
Personally, I have no hatred, but it's more like, you know, it just didn't make sense for that president to go for another 4 years. So personally, I like how Joe Biden is president.
Now that you've gotten a taste of how Generation Z views 2020, let's take a closer look through the lens of a PWI and HBCU and their experience in 2020.
Like normal is over. That normal is over because I know from this day forth, people are always gonna be cautious. I mean, we're going through an era. I call them unprecedented times. These are times no one in the whole world has ever seen. So just, you know, like I said, controlling what I can't control and know that everything is gonna work out. I mean, one day we'll be able to be together again, but for now, let's just adapt. We're adaptable creatures. We can adapt to anything.
Yes, my dad actually tested positive for COVID in March. And this was around the time I was still at PV and I had just got back home. He had been coughing for a while, but I wasn't thinking anything of it. He didn't either, but he got tested anyways. It was really sad and kind of heartbreaking because it was the strongest person in our family, you know, the head of the household. What really gave us motivation to keep pushing through was whenever the doctors were saying that he experienced the worst of his symptoms before we actually started quarantining, and he didn't know. So he didn't experience too much of the pain that a lot of people are experiencing, and I'm just thankful for that.
Coming into COVID, I didn't really take it very seriously. When COVID initially started,
When I went back to work at Walmart, I thought it was just gonna be a regular spring break. Then they told us we had another week off. And once COVID hit and like really forced people to like stay inside and quarantine while at work, you know, I seen people that I was working with catch COVID, but I didn't really think nothing of it because I just thought, I trusted my immune system to the point where like I didn't really care. Like I wasn't trying to wear a mask. I wasn't trying to socially distance, none of those things. And then it kind of hit a little more when a very close friend of mine, well, actually another person that got directed here, Cecily, when her father caught it, and because our family background is kind of similar. So her dad does kind of the same thing that my dad does. So it kind of made it more personal for me.
Being at home with family was very comforting. It did feel like I was back in high school a little bit, because I didn't have as much freedom, which honestly I'm fine with, because like during this quarantine, kind of like lost a little motivation sometimes. So having decisions made for you was kind of a bit of an easy way out that I found to be helpful sometimes.
So my biggest forms of comfort in this time of uncertainty, God, and my friends and my family, just the people that have been surrounding me. I was gonna say food, I'm not gonna lie, food, working on that.
I am a Christian, and just during this time, like, I've been very much, a lot more intentional about my relationship with God and my relationship with other people around me. I know this has been like a really hard time for pretty much everyone my age, and so really pressing into relationships and making sure that people feel loved and know that I'm around and there for them if they need prayer, if they need someone to talk to.
There would be people that would ask like, what time are we closing? And the hours are the same. Like, no, we're closing at 8 o'clock due to COVID stuff. And they give me a side eye. I got flipped off one time. It was actually really, it was funny. But, cause I didn't think people took Walmart being 24 hours that seriously. About halfway through COVID, they shut down the GM side of Walmart. That's the side that's not grocery. And I was grabbing some buggies, and a lady probably in her mid to late 60s was driving by, and she was trying to park, and she seen that there was a sign up there. She was like, wait, so is there a reason why we can't come on this side? And I was like, well, due to COVID and trying to keep things under wraps, our store manager insisted that we close one side of the store. So the lady, mind you, she's in her mid to late 60s, got frustrated, said, I'm sick of this, and proceeded to just speed off. And it's still funny to me also, because I've never seen a lady at this age just speed off like that. And it's just...
Okay, wow, this is so amazing. So yes, I definitely attended the PV protest. And even before the protest, I attended George Floyd's memorial. I think it was like a couple days before that. And then just seeing his body lay there, for me, it made it real. This was a real human being whose life was taken away, just, you know, innocently. Like, he, you know, he didn't deserve that. Leaving his memorial was kind of fueled up and actually more excited to now, you know, attend this PV protest, and then still not truly having justice for Sandra Bland. I came in with the expectations and anticipation of I'm here to be a part of history. I actually led and opened up the protest in prayer. And even in that, I think for me, that was my biggest takeaway, or my biggest, like not accomplishment, but like a biggest moment for me in the protest.
And the first protest that I went to was the one on Fairfax Avenue, which was kind of the big one in Los Angeles where a lot of the police involvement happened. So like there was a staged, or from what I heard on Twitter, was like there was a staged police car that they had burning to like divert protesters and then make it seem like we were inciting the violence when they were inciting the violence. That one had a lot of pushback from the police. So I think that one was like the one that kind of impacted me the most and was like, okay, this is gonna like, this is the beginning of like a larger revolution than like previous protests. Also, like, just being in the protest and being in that, like, space where police are throwing, what is it, tear gas and rubber bullets. Yeah, that's how it really traumatized me.
Well, I've heard a lot of people ask, like, why is it now that there are all these protests and there are all this uproar about everything happening with whether it's racial, whether it's political, whatever the situation is, like, why is it so much now? And me and my family talked about this and we're like, it's because you don't have anything else to do. And now all of a sudden you can't go anywhere, you can't do anything. So the majority of the time you're in front of your TV, you're in front of your phone, majority of the day. But it's like now you don't have anything keeping you from seeing it. Like, to watch a police officer, and I still haven't watched the full video because I refuse to, like, to kneel on his neck, like, you can't miss that because people have been being killed for a long time. The political system has been interesting, I'll say that, for a long time. So I think it's growth in the sense of realizing, oh, the things that we've overlooked or the things that we thought it died down, it didn't die down.
To me, Black Lives Matter means not necessarily negating other lives. It's not saying we're more important. It's just saying, like, we are being attacked. We're not being treated fairly. There's a lot of inequality in society right now, but, like, specifically for Black and Native American lives, I have noticed we get the sort of worst of the treatment. Like, if you were in front of your house, and somebody's, like, your neighbor's house was on fire, you wouldn't call the fire brigade to hose down your house and your neighbor's house. They're the ones who are needing the assistance. And I see that as the same sort of scenario with Black Lives Matter. We're not saying we're more important, we're just saying shine more attention onto us for this moment so we can get the help that we need and the acknowledgement that we deserve to be put onto equal footing with other people. So I would say, first and foremost, like, disclaimer, I'm not a fan of Donald Trump. Not a huge fan of Biden either. It's kind of toss up between, like, two people who have been accused of sexual harassment. It doesn't feel good voting for these candidates. But I would say, like, you have to decide who you want to represent the country. I think Biden has good plans concerning the environment, concerning student loan debts. I think he can present himself well in front of other countries to the point where, you know, we could be taken seriously. That's someone that I'm going to vote for because of those things. I don't think he's gonna get rid of racism, but I think he will do a better job at toning things down. Like, everything is very, like, intense right now. People are racist, are being encouraged to be racist rather than trying to employ, like, a level of, okay, why do you think like this? Like, this is your fellow citizen. You shouldn't be thinking of them as lesser than. You should be, you know, encouraged to try to, like, uphold a level of, like, camaraderie with them.
First, I expect soon to be President Biden, to first put his country back on lockdown. I believe that he really wants to see a change with COVID cases decreasing, and I want to see, like, the health for not only just our age people, but older people too, to be safe. So that's the first thing I would see him do. I see him doing more as far as with the stimulus checks and with helping businesses so they won't be on shutdown, and also to help with college students going through with this COVID cases.
The world is going through a shift right now. And I'm not gonna lie, these presidential elections matter, so definitely go out and vote. But at the same time, if you're gonna think that things are gonna change overnight, you're crazy. Change starts with you looking at yourself and asking yourself, what can I do to make sure someone who does not look like me is treated fairly? You know? And that requires Black parents sitting their kids down, letting them know that you don't really have a privilege. And white parents sitting their kids down, letting them know you have a privilege.
I think I got everything I needed from 2020. Sometimes I have to look away, but even when the TV turns off and the phone goes silent, there's still a pandemic and a revolution happening outside these walls. And as much as we try to escape it, we've got to face it head on. I know I have. Have you?
Slave to our tables. No, we don't know.
Believe like kind of like the caterpillar and the butterfly example, like in the cocoon. Like I really believe like by the time I hit January 31st, 2020, I'm gonna be like that butterfly that has sprouted out the cocoon. And like this is all just my cocoon season.
It reminds me of the message we had back in the 60s with the civil rights. It's showing me that the message never died. What things we did back when our ancestors and our grandparents seen, we still living their dream they want to see.
Yeah, that's how it feels to be. It feels like I'm not living it, like my real life.
2020 has been wild. But for me, I just been saying, I just want God's will to be done and I want God to align my steps every step of the way. And I don't want to have to worry so much about what's going on.
But my mind is focused on bigger and greater things, that these little microaggressions or whatever, somebody calls me the N-word or says something like sus racism stuff at me, like, what am I supposed to do, cry, protest? Well, get on Twitter white people look at me funny. All I care is about the relationships I build and the things I have to achieve. Haters don't matter. Racists don't matter to me. They're beneath me, literally. They're focused that negative energy on me. That says more about them than me. I don't care about them.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye. Great job.
Yeah.
You did great.
You too.
It was cold and they saw I wasn't old. I'm just a kid, but the police didn't show any remorse for what they did. My pain in their eyes open, I seen someone in the street. I went over to help them and realized the body was me. Mommy, it's okay, I just don't wanna see you.